Well, Newt Gingrich is a pretty popular guy lately. He's surging in the polls, riding high on a buzzworthy debate performance, and he just earned an endorsement from the New Hampshire union leader. That's right there in Mitt Romney's backyard. Even if Bill Clinton, or even Bill Clinton, is pouring in on the praise for Gingrich's thoughtful approach to immigration. Take a listen.
He thinks about this stuff all the time. He's articulate, and he tries to think of a conservative version of an idea that will solve a legitimate problem.
All right, well, joining us live, CNN contributor John Avalon and CNN.com contributor Elsie Grandison. Guys, so Bill Clinton says that Newt Gingrich gives independent voters something to think about. Elsie?
Well, you know, definitely what he said will give independent voters something to think about, but the person who said it won't. I just think President Clinton is being a very smart politician, and that he's setting people up to vote for Gingrich because Gingrich would be easily defeated in the general election. I think it's a smart move, and I think it's also a move that works on President Obama's behalf.
John, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, Democrats would love to run against Newt Gingrich. And the sort of sad fact is, it was a sincere compliment. Newt Gingrich, circa 2007, when he was talking about building broad coalitions, could have appealed to independent voters. But in this incarnation, where he's throwing red meat, talking about secular socialists in the White House, that alienates independent voters from the get-go.
All right, Elsie, you mentioned Obama. If Gingrich earned the GOP nomination, let's talk about how he would fare against the president.
Well, I don't see him doing much beyond his base. And even his base, in my opinion, is a bit eroded because people haven't forgotten the Newt Gingrich of the 90s. And when I mean people, I mean the religious conservatives. It still has a bad taste in their mouths. And so I don't see Gingrich having the ability to reach beyond what you see right now, which is just a little buzz about anyone besides Romney. And that's really what it is. Even the newspaper and everyone's talking about, they've only picked one person who've actually won the presidency, and that was Ronald Reagan back in 1980. So that's not really as big as a deal as we're saying right now.
All right, John's smiling.
Well, yeah, I mean, first of all, give Newt his due. I mean, I think he will surge in the polls in New Hampshire and elsewhere, in part because of this endorsement. Romney camp can't be happy because of it. And there is this glass ceiling that Romney has, and Newt could coalesce some of the anti-Romney vote. But when you pivot to the general, that's when things get fun. And you start gaming that out, you start asking yourself questions like, could President Obama win 40 states with a 40% approval rating? That becomes a new bar, and it's sort of fun to think about as you play it ahead.
All right, guys.